I'm back! Told you I was gonna be back, dude! Because here in Sandusky, Ohio, near where we live, we have movie theaters! Evidently, a lot of places do not have movie theaters. And I love it. I love it. Where I'm like, I'll see anything movie. Like, normally I wouldn't even have gone to see the movie that I just got out of with Liam Neeson called The Marksman. That's like a movie that I would probably wait to watch on like streaming or whatever. But screw that, dude! Can't sit in the house no more, dude. So, movies. As long as it has an actor in it that I like at all, I'm gonna go see said movie, man. Oh, my name is Old School, and I do movie reviews. This is year six. 6 years to do movie reviews. So like I just said, we just got out of seeing The Marksman. All right, so what I do here, if you don't know, if you're new to these videos, I just give you the thoughts off the top of my head immediately. I don't write this down, I don't script it, dude. I just shoot it out at you for your enjoyment, dude. So, I like this movie. I thought this was a good movie, dude. You really liked it.
I
thought it was a little slow in the middle, but the ending, such a good ending, dude. Now, what this movie is, right, without giving away too much, because the trailers don't really give you too much of an idea what's going on. It's a lot like the movie I saw last week with Tom Hanks. News of the World, right? That was like Tom Hanks had to take this girl like across country and stuff like this. And this movie is Liam Neeson has to take... Okay, so basically Liam Neeson is a Arizona rancher, right? He works on like a ranch. There's a lot of illegal aliens crossing the border right on his property where his ranch is, right? And circumstances develop that Liam Neeson has to take this young little boy named Miguel all the way up to Chicago and stuff to save him from the drug cartels. And we hate drug cartels! Dude, like, I wish America would get on the ball and do something with Mexico to, like, help eliminate drug cartels, man. Because these dudes are murderous freaks, dude. And they make perfect bad guys for movies like this. It's weird, because this movie's a lot like popcorn. There it was. I thought I could get through one damn review without popcorn working its way out of my fucking teeth, dude. This movie was a lot like the last Rambo movie, Rambo Last Blood, because that was also about drug cartels. Kind of a very similar story, man. But this had more heart, right? Because Liam Neeson is playing a more older, grizzled type of ex-military dude, man. And it's a very simple movie where it's character-driven aspect of connecting to the characters with the audience is what made this so enjoyable, I think, man. Great acting all around. Not a lot of action. It's not like a two-fisted gunner, like Taken or some shit like that, man. But definitely, if you're a fan of Liam Neeson, he puts in a great portrayal, man. And he does a pretty decent Arizona type of American accent. Didn't really have his normal Liam accent in it and stuff like that. Definitely enjoyable. The ending was spot on. Like, and not just the ending, like the whole like second half of the third act was like perfect, dude. Overall, I thought it was good. There's not too much I can really say about it other than it was a good Liam Neeson movie. And like, it fits right in there with like everything else Liam's ever done, like Gunshy or The Gray and like all that stuff, man. So if you're a fan of Liam Neeson and you can't sit in the house no more and you gotta get the hell out of there, dude, and you have movie theaters open near you, I suggest going to see The Marksman. I'm gonna give it 3.5. Give it 3.5. I just want a little bit more action, but I will say that it was so topical for now. And they actually mentioned in the movie how Liam Neeson's character does not trust, he's not a big fan of the American government at the time. You know what I mean? Because of immigration, everything that's going on in the country. So, yeah, it's two movies in a row that were very solid, very good, and both touched on topical things that are happening in our country right now. So, I'm just editing right here, man. Not every review has to be outrageously long or extremely funny. So, I ain't got no jokes for this one, man. It's a serious tone. It's like a serious movie and stuff. So, all right, guys. Told you I was going to be back next weekend. I didn't even know that this movie was coming out this week. I have no idea what the movies are coming out. I don't know that they moved Godzilla up from May to March. So, that's fantastic, man. So, expect more reviews. And thank you all for supporting these reviews, because really the reason why I came back to doing them is because I kept getting asked about, where's the reviews? Well, here's one. Hope you enjoyed it. Peace.